Hey fellow beauty finders, this is Matthias. I am so excited because the summer has begun. Well, it's not officially the first day of summer yet, but it's getting hot over here in Los Angeles. It's heating up, and I wanted to share with you something really exciting that happened this spring. I was asked by the American Beauty Association to speak on behalf of Face Atelier Cosmetics at the makeup show in downtown Los Angeles just a month or two ago. And I had a great time speaking with Erica Lee, who is in charge of all of the interviews and all of the press. She's a fellow makeup artist. She was a dear, sweet, sweet soul. So I want to share with you the sit-down interview in my Monday Makeup Chat coming up right now.
I'm here with Matthias, who is going to speak with us about Face Atelier and all of its amazingness.
Yes.
But before we start to speak about this product, I want to know more about you. What do you do? What is your background? Anything like that?
Okay. Well, Erica, I've been doing makeup for over 15 years. I've been living in Los Angeles. I go to the East Coast once in a while. But I've been working at E! Television for over 8 years. Okay. I've been working on a show called The Soup with Joel McHale, who's my main guy. I do grooming for him. And I've done various shows and things over there as well. I also have private clients. I do weddings. I do drag queens at Halloween time. I started out as an impersonator and a performer myself.
Really?
I was an actor and a theater person as a kid. I fell into loving makeup because I just didn't have the stamina to go on all those auditions for being an actor, so I gave that up. But then I realized as a professional makeup artist, you're always auditioning. You're always meeting clients. You're always like trying to get the next job.
Yes.
You're always auditioning. So it's like I gave up one career because I didn't want to audition, and yet I'm always auditioning.
And you're often auditioning when you don't even know you're auditioning.
Oh, yeah.
Because people are watching all the time.
Oh, yeah. I had a high-profile celebrity ask, have a producer ask if I could do her makeup because she was going to a party and she was looking for a new makeup artist. I don't want to mention who, but I said, okay, well, great, yeah, I'd love to do her makeup. She's looking for a new makeup artist. What's the rate? Oh, there's no rate. She's not paying. She's testing people out. So I said, okay. So I went to her house, did her makeup. She was like, you have 30 minutes. I don't like sitting in the makeup chair. I'm like, I have 30 minutes. Okay. All right. I'm trying to make small talk with
her.
I'm trying to, you know,
engage.
Talk and engage and this and that. And she didn't want to have it. She's like, can you just move a little faster, please? So needless to say, it didn't go very well. But you're always auditioning no matter what you do. Okay. So anyway, that's my
story. But that didn't go well. But you woke up the next day and you did it again.
Oh, yeah, you did it again. And I learned so much. I learned from that experience. I learned not to take things personally. I learned that actors and actresses are very, very busy. They meet a lot of different people. You know, they can't, like, hold your hand and love you every time they meet you. It's in that. It's a big world out there, so don't get your feelings hurt because one person doesn't call you back. Just brush it off and move on.
Keep on
totally,
moving.
Totally, totally.
Okay, yeah. So I want to learn more about this. I absolutely know about this product because it's what I'm wearing today.
Yes, the Ultra
and
Foundation.
I am obsessed. It's fantastic, as I said before, for print, film, and the everyday woman.
Yes.
Now, so let's talk about that.
The one thing that I like to explain about Ultra Foundation that's unlike a lot of other foundations is, as Debbie explained, it's a silicone-based foundation. And so a silicone-based foundation is going to give you a very smooth, flawless coverage. Silicone is a great, great ingredient. And the Face Atelier Foundation, unlike other silicone-based foundations, is actually twice as dense. There's like twice the amount of coverage in this foundation as there are in a lot of other silicone-based foundations. So a little tiny bit, here, let me show you on your hand, goes a very long way. It's very
opaque.
It's
very dense.
It's very dense. If you use a foundation brush, it goes on very sheer, but it's still a medium coverage. Sheer, not in transparent, sheer as in easy and blendable and breathable. If you use your fingertip and use your fingers to rub it into your skin, it still goes on perfect and smooth. There are so many foundations out there that if you don't use a sponge or if you don't use a foundation brush, it goes on and it looks heavy like butter.
Yeah.
Like just too much.
You better buff it in.
You better buff it in.
Yes.
But with Face Atelier, it doesn't look like that. So if you just want to use a couple drops and run out the door, it looks flawless.
And that's true because I actually almost always use a brush when I apply, and I usually do use a buffing brush. But the other day I forgot my brush and I did it with my fingers.
Uh-huh.
And I was happy. I was like, okay, this worked. It went on well. I got the coverage I needed. Mm-hmm. It still looks like skin.
Yes.
I was really, really happy with it. So that's true. And there's a lot of everyday women out there that really don't invest in a ton of brushes.
Right.
This is the tool.
Right. And so, they want to spend 5 minutes doing their makeup.
Yes.
So you don't want to make it that you're going to have to like worry about it looking perfect if you just want to throw it on.
It's a beautiful finish. It is a dewier finish.
Mm-hmm.
So
it is much dewier. There's another silicone-based foundation out on the market that is super popular with HD in the title, and it dries to much more of a matte finish. So if you are over a certain age and you want more of a dew or more of a glow, this is a much more hydrating looking foundation for the skin.
Yeah, it's
and
beautiful.
The other thing that I really, really, really love for the pro artists out there, or for just women who don't want to spend a lot of money and buy like three different foundations, one for the winter, one for the spring, one for the summer, is that we have the adjusters. Debbie is incredible for creating the adjusters. You have the zero negative, and then you have the zero plus. So these are the two basics. The zero negative will lighten any foundation, and the zero plus will deepen any foundation. So if you have this foundation, and this is your 6 months out of the year color.
Right.
But if you tend to get very, very, very washed out or fair in the winter time, you can actually take these two, mix them together, and get a whole new foundation
out of it. That's amazing.
So that's with the
zero
minus.
That's a great product.
It's so, so amazing that you can do that. And then if you get a little warmer.
You're going to give me a tan.
In the summertime, yes.
If you get a
little warmer in the summertime, rather than get a whole new foundation for your June, July, and August months, you can just take these two, mix them together, and then you get a deeper hue from your same one bottle of foundation.
So the zero plus and the zero negative, does it only work with the Face Atelier product? Let's say somebody has a favorite foundation, even though they should try Face Atelier.
Right.
But if they don't, will these products work with other foundations?
These products will work with 9 out of 10 foundations. Now, it's the same thing that I say with people who say, is this, I've worked for other lines, I've worked with tons of foundations, I work with models and actors. And one of the questions I always get is this non-comedogenic? And I say, well, there's always a slight chance that there's some chemistry that is not going to work with, say, even Clinique's three-step program.
Right.
You know what I mean? You never know.
Right.
So I would say 9 out of 10 foundations this will work with. There are foundations that are, there are tinted moisturizers that are like that gel base,
yes.
That kind of like watery gel base.
Yeah, there is
or those foundations from like, that are like mousses.
Yes.
You know those whipped
yes.
mousses? I would venture to guess that this may not work with the mousses and those gels. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But with the creamy liquid foundations, whether they're silicone based or not, you know what I mean? 9 out of 10, it will work
It's gonna work. So try it. It's
yeah.
worth the try.
Now let's talk about heat.
Because
you
about
asked
heat.
About heat. So heat is great. If you're a professional makeup artist and you work with a lot of African American skin tones or even East Indian skin tones,
yes.
you know, very deep, very tan.
Yes.
Heat and Zero Plus Plus are going to be an incredible kit addition for you. Now, if you are Caucasian and you like to do a lot of self-tanner, if you like to go get a spray tan or do those tanning pads or tanning lotions, a lot of times the tanner will turn you slightly orange, okay? It's just
the
way
it
works.
Yes.
Heat will also work to add to your foundation and make it a little bit more warm. I hate to use the word orange because nobody wants to look orange. But the truth is, if your self-tanner and chest are very, very deep, kind of bronzy,
right.
pumpkinish a little bit, and you
warm,
put on
warm.
A very light yellow olive foundation from your favorite brand, you're gonna look like you have a mask of olive foundation and a very pumpkiny warm suntan. So I think a little bit of heat would work very well mixed in to the two. So I'm gonna put a couple drops right there on Erica's hand. A little bit more, mix it in. Just to give you a little bit more of a peachy, warm tone.
Now that's the color I would be if I could have it my way.
Right? It's like a tan moment.
Right.
Having a tan moment with just adding a little bit of heat to your foundation.
And it's gonna last that long.
Well, the great thing about makeup is you can wash it off. You know, sometimes those self-tanners we want to wash off. You go to ever go to get spray tan and it starts peeling and it's getting all weird in your clavicle area and you're like, oh, I wish this would wash off, right? Well, with makeup, you can wash it off. Now, a 0++ is a pure, rich, dark chocolate. And it's not cool toned and it's not warm toned. It's like neutral. Very, very neutral. So a little bit of this right here for a darker foundation. Say you have a foundation in your kit and it's just not quite dark enough for that beautiful black model or that beautiful black actress. You take a little bit of 0++.
Oh, that's really rich. That's beautiful.
Mix that in. If your actress is African American and she has less of an olive undertone and more of a warmer undertone, mix a little bit of heat in there to warm it up. Can you guys see the difference?
This is really important for a makeup artist or somebody who's maybe just discovering makeup and they are of darker tone, because I often have darker complexion people sit down in my chair and have that look of panic. Can this white girl do my makeup?
Oh yeah, for sure.
And you know, it's because they've been
made ashy.
Absolutely. And so these colors may not, they may look like orange really, but for a woman of color, warming up the skin is everything.
Oh my gosh, this is the ash buster.
Yes.
Because if we use like taupes and olives and kind of neutral beigey powders on black toned skin, you get this ashy gray
It's a beautiful gray look.
Yes, so if you really warm up the skin, and a great pro artist tip is that if you only have very deep taupey powders in your kit, and you know that you have to powder this African American client, I personally would overuse the heat. Make her maybe twice as orange as she needs to be, because you know then that when you powder her with your taupey powder,
it'll bring it back. Perfect.
Yeah, so that's why I use this for.
This is a fantastic product.
Here, let me clean your hand for you, because I want to show you the new Ultra Skin Foundation.
Now this one I haven't tried before, so what's the difference with this?
Okay. So Debbie, who created Face Atelier Ultra Pro Foundation, knew that she had an amazing medium to full coverage foundation that you could sheer out with a foundation brush or with a sponge. But she wanted to create something that was going to feel like moisturizer but still give the same silicone long-lasting wear of her Ultra Pro. So then she created Ultra Skin. So the Ultra Skin Foundation, let's see what number is this. This is number 6. The Ultra Skin Foundation feels just as easy and light and breathable, but it has a silicone base. It's just not as full coverage as the Ultra Foundation. So it's more of a light to medium coverage that you can actually build up. And it comes in 12 shades. So the shades match, you know, all of the Ultra Pros, and then there's a few extras added in. Let me show you 11.5. So 11.5 is a little warmer. This will show up great on camera. So I've worn both foundations because I just like to look flawless all the time. And this is much, much, much more of a fuller coverage. So when I really want to be camera ready, I wear Ultra Pro, like today.
Every day wear.
But when I am doing kind of like just meet and greets, or I'm going out to lunch with my girlfriends or my clients, I'll do Ultra Skin. I'm not going to be on camera, but I would still want to look perfect. So, but you can use this on camera. You know, oftentimes you'll work with a model who has like perfect skin.
They don't really need anything, but they need a little something.
A little something. Yes. That's what I would recommend the Ultra Skin.
That's a great
addition to the line.
Perfect.
You know what I mean? It's just a great added benefit. It's like the next generation.
So if makeup artist or the everyday consumer, where can an everyday consumer and makeup artist purchase this product?
At faceatelier.com.
Okay.
Go to the website. Sign up for the pro discount.
Okay.
I believe Debbie asked for a certain amount of credentials. Business cards, you know, call sheets, things like that, to prove that you are a working makeup artist. But the discount is good worldwide. You get, I believe, 40% off of our products at the website, which is a great way. There's a couple other places like
Camera Ready Cosmetics,
right? That's what you said.
Yes. Right. And I believe Nigel's.
Oh, of course. If you're in Los Angeles,
Nigel's,
and you want to go to Nigel's Beauty Emporium, yes, we are definitely at Nigel's Beauty Emporium.
Okay, and we should mention this: it is cruelty free.
Oh, very important.
It's cruelty free.
We don't kill any little monkeys or animals, seeing if their eyes turn red by putting this on their skin. No, we don't do that. We only test on people who are willing to
test it out,
and agree to, you know, trying that out. We're cruelty free. No
Perfect.
Animal harming. Yes, in our products.
Before we wrap it up,
yes.
How can people find out more about you?
Oh, well, I am on Twitter and Instagram at Matthias4Makeup and the little number 4.
Okay.
I also have a YouTube channel.
Okay.
I post 3 videos a week. You can go to youtube.com/karma33. K with a K,
okay.
With a karma. Karma 33. Karma because I believe in what goes around comes around, and 33 is my lucky number. So you can find me, and my name is Matthias Allen.
Thank you so much, Matthias.
Thank you, Erica. Thank you.
I hope you guys enjoyed that behind-the-scenes look at my day at the makeup show. As always, I would love for you guys to subscribe to my channel because I am a working makeup artist here in Los Angeles, and I always post behind-the-scenes tutorials, tips and tricks, and on-set adventures. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter for daily behind-the-scenes pics at Matthias for Makeup. Also, I am going to put a link down below with exclusive product purchase codes to some of my favorite Face Atelier products, so you must try them out. And also check out one of my other 2 videos before you go, and don't forget to subscribe, and I always appreciate a comment and a thumbs up, so please leave one down below.
Bye.